This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Fault Analysis and Power Systems, Part 3c-1. In this series on fault analysis and power systems, our objective is to hand calculate the current and voltage quantities for various faults. In this video, we will see how phase, current, and voltage quantities are calculated for a line-to-line fault on line B and C on the 13.8 kV side of the transformer. So let's continue with our example, which was introduced in the previous parts. We have a three-phase synchronous generator having a short circuit capability of 600 MVA short circuit connected to a 115 kV bus. A delta Y transformer rated at 30 MVA connects the 115 kV bus to the 13.8 kV bus and has a positive and zero sequence impedance of 10% at 30 MVA. Step 1 of our calculation asked us to convert our system into per unit values. That is exactly what we did in part 2b of our series. Here we redraw the same network. Before we draw the converted sequence network diagram, let's take a look at the type of fault in hand. The phase-to-phase fault on the 13.8 kV system should look something like this. Let us ignore the 1x and 2x current on the high voltage side and instead focus on the low voltage side of the transformer. We have a line-to-line fault on the 13.8 kV side in which phase B and C are involved. The fault current on phase B flows towards the point of the fault. However, on phase C, the fault current is flowing away from the point of the fault. Therefore, for a phase-to-phase fault, we should expect the fault current on both phases to be equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Now let us go through the hand calculations and verify this result. Next, we move to step number 2, which asked us to identify the type of fault involved. As mentioned before, we have a line-to-line fault, which is unsymmetrical fault type, meaning an unbalanced fault. This type of fault produces sequence quantities, positive and negative sequence components, current and voltage quantities. However, due to the nature of a line-to-line fault, it does not have a ground mode. Therefore, we should not expect any zero sequence current flowing for a line-to-line fault. Next, we move to step number 3, which asks us to make a sequence network from the per unit converted system. So we draw the positive sequence network, and we also draw the negative sequence network. Again, we don't have a zero sequence network because we have a line-to-line fault, which does not have a ground mode. And then in step number 4, we will draw the faulted sequence network based on the type of fault we have. Now, given that the fault is a line-to-line fault, as we mentioned before, we will connect the positive and negative sequence networks in parallel. This we will discuss in great detail in our video on a line-to-line fault in topic 2, which is the derivation of sequence network diagrams of our series. But for now, we will just redraw a parallel connected faulted network. To give a brief description of the faulted network, we basically have a positive sequence and negative sequence networks connected in parallel at the point of the fault. Line-to-line faults that are, although unsymmetrical, are not connected to ground, which means that zero sequence current will not be able to flow from ground into the fault. And this explains why zero sequence networks are omitted from the construction of the faulted sequence network. This also tells us that our subsequent calculations for finding fault current and voltage quantities, zero sequence components will totally be ignored and considered zero. So let's move towards step number 5 and hand calculate the sequence current quantities. First, we set up a base value, then we proceed to sequence current calculations. The positive sequence current will be the fault current inside the loop, which can be found by dividing the voltage with the total impedance in the loop as follows. The pre-fault voltage is 1 per unit at the angle of 0 degrees, and then the impedance in the loop is the sum of the positive and negative sequence impedance. That is J.05 plus J.10 plus J.10 plus J.05 per unit. And when we compute this, we get negative J.3.333 per unit. Now this is the positive sequence current that is flowing through the connected sequence network, and this is the per unit value. Now we must calculate the current value in amperes. So first we take the base value of power, which is 30 MVA divided by the base value of the voltage at the faulted end, 13.8 kV, which gives us the base value of current at 1255 amperes. Multiply that base value of 1255 amperes by the per unit, and we actually get the ampere current that is flowing through the positive sequence network. And that is 4184 at negative 90 degrees. It is also evident from the faulted sequence network that the positive and negative sequence current will be equal in magnitude because they are the same current in the loop, with a difference being that they have an opposite direction, meaning that they are flowing in the opposite direction from each other. To account for that, we give a 180 degrees phase shift in the positive sequence current to find the negative sequence current. So the negative sequence current simply equals 4184 amperes at the angle of positive 90 degrees. Instead of negative 90 degrees for the positive sequence. So again, negative sequence current equals 4184 at the angle of positive 90 degrees. And as mentioned before, there will be no zero sequence component for a line-to-line fault. Next, we move to step number 6 to convert the sequence component values to phase current values. We have our old familiar set of three-phase transformation equations. And since there is no zero sequence current, they can be simplified even further to the following. Now, after plugging in the value of 1 at angle 120 degrees for the A operator, and 1 angle 240 degrees for the A squared operator, the 4184 amps at angle of negative 90 degrees for the positive sequence current, and 4184 amps at the angle of positive 90 degrees for negative sequence current, what we finally get is the following. We find that the fault current in phase A is 0, and the fault current in phase B and C are equal and opposite of each other. This can be further explained intuitively by the fact that we have assumed that phase B and C phases are shorted, and hence there were no fault current in phase A because it was the unfaulted phase and does not carry any fault current. Phase B and C current quantities are the faulted phase and they should be the same magnitude but opposite in direction, which is evident by the hand calculations. This matches well with the diagram that we drew earlier. Now for part 3c-2, we will calculate the voltage quantities for a phase-to-phase fault. We hope that you find this video tutorial valuable and useful as a professional or student. Please support us by becoming our patron and donating through patreon.com/generalpack. Your generous donation will help us continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Thank you.